This is the Jason Walker Show. Two-time National Sports Media Association Montana Sportscaster of the Year and three-time loser, the Jason Walker Show, the best local and statewide sports coverage, featuring the biggest guests from Montana.
Flint Rasmussen joining us here on the Jason Walker Show.
He's freaking exhausting, too. You used to dance a lot more. Yeah, I know, lady. I'm 51 years old now.
The NAIA Hall of Famer, Mike Van Dees, joining us here, Jason Walker Show. And is it just a deal where quarterbacks have to be good golfers?
Well, that's all they have time for. They don't work out. They don't lift weights. They don't do anything else. They might as well go get on the golf course, at least have some fun.
And from across the country,
Doug Gottlieb, our guest here on the Jason Walker Show.
End of the day, remember, it's your show. It's got your name on it.
Howie Mandel, our guest here.
Jason Walker, deal or no deal?
The Jason Walker Show.
Hey, what up? Happy Wednesday, Jason Walker Show. Back inside the off-the-wall advertising man cave and excited for a big one today. We're going to talk to Katie Garcin-Forba, Capital Girls coach. They've won four in a row. We're going to talk with Aubrey McMaster from Jefferson. Jefferson girls ranked fifth in the state. And Ben Dudek from Helena High girls. They've won four in a row. They'll join us coming up as well. You can always watch on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. Listen on Podbean, Network One Sports, Network One Sports, Spotify. You can also watch on Rumble. Where else are we at? SoundCloud, mention Spotify, Apple, Google. We're everywhere. You can go to Jason Walker Show or jasonwalkermedia.com for anything that you need, including Continental Divide Radio. Your home for the music of your memories. So, there you go. Good stuff. Good stuff. Let's see here. News last night that came out late last night. The Grizzlies of Montana will have a brand new quarterback next year. Cliff McDowell announced late last night he is entering the transfer portal. He's got a year of eligibility left. He was the Big Sky Newcomer of the Year. Helped lead the Grizz to the national championship game. Said he's going to be forever a Grizz. But he is going to be going to his fifth higher education level school, college, in 5 years. Started his college career at Louisiana Lafayette, was at Kilgore College in Central Arkansas, and then Southern, but changed his commitment to the Grizz last year. So he is off and running after throwing for over 2,000 yards, 13 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. He's 1-0 against the Cats. He's also second on the team in rushing yards and rushing touchdowns with 9. So he is out. Sam Vidlick is your other returning quarterback. Let's see here. Taylor Housewright looks like he's leaving. Sources telling 406mtsports.com that the offensive coordinator, quarterback's coach from Montana State, is heading to Akron. MSU hasn't announced it. Football Scoop first reporting it. He's from Ohio, which is from Ashland, Ohio, which is about 50 miles west of Akron. The Zips play in the Mid-America Conference FBS team. They both are, I think that is probably good for Montana State. Housewright, just big games, had trouble making the right play calls. And I know the coaches don't run the plays, but when you don't use arguably the great athlete, the best athlete in FCS in your three losses, and Sean Chambers. And one report that I've been told, or one source told me, actually more than one source told me, that Houseright was upset with Chambers for the Idaho game, and that's why he didn't play a lot. Partially injured for the Grizz game, allegedly. Apparently for the North Dakota State game, he wasn't at 100% either, but who is at that level of the season? But I'm excited to see what Brent Vegan brings in, who he brings in, who he promotes from internal. But Houseright, according to Football Scoop and 406mtsports.com, is headed out to Akron, heading home, which is good. But as a Bobcat fan, I'm not upset about that. I think the Cats need a little bit different offense. You can't rely on one dude and Tommy Mellott. You can't rely on one style of offense. You've got to be able to throw the ball, especially in the Big Sky. I love the run game. Don't get me wrong. I love the run game. But when you have eight running backs and you prefer to use your quarterbacks as the runners, hey, I could be hard on the Cats too, just like I am on the Grizz. And I don't know what the Grizz are going to do at quarterback next year. Sam Vidlak was not the answer this year, that's for sure. The walk-up brought to you by Montana Custom Log Homes, the premier log home company in the industry. Veteran-owned, family-owned, woman-owned, and operated, yourcustomlog.com is where you go. Results from last night in the AA. Second-ranked Hellgate knocked off Helena High in overtime, 59-53. Bengal boys were up 12 at the half and gave up 9-point deficit in the third quarter, and then were outscored. Easton Sant, 17 for Hellgate. Tevin Wetzel had 26. Jackson Lieberg, 15 in the loss. Helena High has now lost two straight in OT and 1-6 on the year. Capital Boys, the upset of fourth-ranked Sentinel on the road, 39-35. Cole Dawes, 13. Dylan Omquist, Connor Toivonen, 9 apiece. And I don't know what nationality the last name is, a Toivonen, but I like it. It sounds like a hockey name, Connor Toivonen. I love it. Let's see. Glacier beat Big Sky on the boys' side. Cohen Kastelitz had 19. Class A last night, Butte Central, 24-point win over Frenchtown. Lockwood is ranked fourth, beat Hardin. Top-ranked Loyola won on the boys' side. Seventh-ranked Manhattan, number four St. Labre. And on the girls' side, fifth-ranked Helena girls with a 10-point win. In fact, we'll talk to Ben Dudek coming up in just a couple of minutes. Capital beat Sentinel by 16. Gallatin destroyed Belgrade, 67-18. And second-ranked Big Sky beat Glacier by 22, 48-26. Lockwood upset Hardin girls. I know Lockwood's girls are 6-3, but that's a good basketball team they just beat in Hardin, who upset Haver. Danny Jordan had 17 for Lockwood. Third-ranked Frenchtown girls got a win. Polson beat Whitefish in overtime. Sixth-ranked Missoula Loyola in girls, 64-10 over Arlee. It was 30-2 in the first quarter. Oh, this is boys. No, that's girls. Yeah, that was girls. And Manhattan beat Lone Peak by 20. So Kingston Hugs for the Hardin boys had 37. Ethan Stack of Loyola had 31. It's a big games there. Garson Gulick, Whitefish, 29. Loyola, Reynolds Johnston, 27. Geo Horner, 26. Mentioned Tevin Wetzel's 26 for Helena High. There was some good scoring last night, including Avery Kraft, who poured in 22 for Helena High, which has now won 4 straight. And joining us on this Wednesday to talk about his team and the next game is the head coach of the Bengal girls, Ben Dudek, on the Jason Walker Show.
All right. Make it, 4 in a row for the Helena High girls. Congrats, coach. How are you?
Yeah, thank you. Doing well. Got another one tonight. So, you know, trying to get ready and get these kids on a bus and go for one more.
You're tonight, not tomorrow?
It is tonight, yep.
Okay. Crazy schedules this time of the year.
It is. You know, everybody's trying to make it work. You know, everybody's got different stuff going on in the gyms. Gym access is one of those things that you kind of have to deal with. But, you know, one of our things, you know, consistently has always been we'll play anybody, anytime, anywhere. So just put it on the schedule. We'll go play.
Wow, you guys sound like a TCU or, you know, we want Bama.
Yeah, we like it hard.
There you go. Well, you guys have been playing hard. As I mentioned, 4 straight wins, another big one last night. 10-point victory, but the second quarter kind of put things away for you guys last night. What is it about basketball in general that there's certain stretches of, you know, and Gary Turcott over at Carroll says for a long time, basketball is a game of runs. What is it about different quarters that make runs happen?
You know, honestly, I think with us, you have to limit those major runs from other teams, number one, right? Mm-hmm. So that comes in with defensive efficiency and consistency. So you got to limit big runs from our teams. And I think for us, it's consistently, you know, the message has just been, we have to continue playing the right way. You know, we're not going to blow teams out. Nobody's going to blow teams out consistently by, you know, 20 or 30 teams going to keep on coming at you. It happened kind of on Saturday with us with Glacier. But if we continue to play the right way, there's going to be stretches in the games we play really well. And those can be games that make, or those can be stretches that make the difference. And yesterday that was 100% the case in the second. And that was honestly the talk after the first quarter. We're playing well. We're getting the ball to where we need to get it to. We're not defending necessarily the way we normally do. But if we continue to do those things, we're going to continue to put ourselves in the position to win the game. You know, and luckily, that second quarter was an 18-7 quarter that put us in great position in the second half to win.
You had 4 players in double figures last night. Yeah, Avery Kraft led the way, but balanced scoring attack. I know the defense is the focus. You got to score more than the other team, but when you have balance like that and get 4 in double figures, you're going to win a lot of games.
Yeah, we've been balanced the whole year. You know, I think that's only Avery's second time leading the team in scoring. You know, Maddie's led a couple of times. Kylie's led, once. Grace has led once, also has had, you know, games she's at, you know, 13 and 12. And then we have good consistent scoring off the bench too. Even those girls that don't put up double figures, you know, we're getting 6 and 5 and 7 from other contributors. So, you know, the ball's moving really well and we're playing good team basketball. So we'll have to continue to do that.
You know, and it's funny too, when you look at it, because, you know, you get those bench players and they might be unhappy a little times they're coming off the bench, but when they can sit and realize, hey, if I get 4 points tonight, that helps my team, because if this girl gets 5, if she gets 2, it all adds up. And, you know, it's math at the end of the day, but it helps become a good role player if you recognize how things work out. And Steve Keller, the great Hall of Fame coach in Montana, said a lot for, told me last year, he goes, look, if I can get the guy that I'm guarding to score less than me, we're going to have a good chance to win. And if all 5 guys on the court or girls on the court buy into that, you're going to win.
Oh yeah, exactly. And we got a group that has bought into their roles. You know, they understand that different games bring different situations, and in different games, you know, some girls are going to score, but we're all about, you know, it's not about how many or it's not about whether I can score, it's about whether we're scoring, you know, right. And sometimes when we're scoring, it is the eye, it is you scoring, you might be the best option, you might have the shot, you might have the drive, but all we care about at the end of the day is the one that goes next to the W column, you know, that's the number that we want to care about. We don't really care who puts it in the basket.
When you look at a player like an Avery or whoever's hot that night, what do you say to the rest of the team during a timeout? Like, do you guys recognize that this person's going off? Get them the ball?
Well, there's different matchups that we, you know that we're going to have, you know, pregame. And then obviously as the game goes, you kind of see how their adjustments are going. So, you know, we're consistently looking for matchups and what we can exploit on the other team's defensive side of the ball. I think we've been doing that, you know, a nice job with the past couple games. You know, I think, you know, Glacier's, you know, one of those examples where Glacier was really keying on Kylie. And Kylie kind of had a difficult time getting some shots up, but, you know, but she understands that, and that kind of opens up everything else. You know, and that's the thing. It's, you know, we're a team, I think, where if you try to key on one of our players, I think we can bite you pretty easily with three or four other girls.
Sure.
You know, the girls all understand that and they bought into that. And that's, I think, why we're seeing a lot of success on the offensive side of the ball.
You got a tough road game tonight at Sentinel. They took it last night to Capital by 10, but they've got some pretty good scores, and it starts for them with Emily McElmurray. But how do you defend against Sentinel tomorrow night or tonight?
Yeah, they do have a couple good scorers, not only McElmurray, but Mastro as well. She can definitely fill it up from behind the arc, and she's a good finisher and attacker. We just got to stay disciplined. Obviously, there's going to be a plan to stop McElmurray, or to try to contain her, not stop her, because she is a great player. You know, but to try to contain her, you know, getting out to shooters is going to be a key against Sentinel, because they are a good shooting team, even outside those two, and they have consistently been over the years. So we're just going to have to be really well disciplined in our assignments, and make sure that we defend well from the perimeter.
Ben Dudek joining us, Helena High girls coach. There's not a lot of great stuff that happened today or national days. So Monday was National Bubble Bath Day. When was the last time you took a bubble bath?
Probably when I was two.
You're not
been a shower person. I've been a shower person since I was. And I like cold baths. So.
Ooh.
So I'll do those after runs and stuff. You know, help recover the body, but so cold baths all the time, but bubble baths, it's been a minute.
Well, you can put bubbles in cold water.
I could, but I don't want to be in there that long.
I've been telling coaches this: if you win state, bubble bath, they're on the show, camera strategically placed.
if we win state, I'll throw some bubbles in in the lake and go jump in it.
No. We got to have some incentive here, coach. That's not happening, I can tell.
No.
You know, some coaches shave their head. Some coaches shave a beard. I'm just trying to think outside the box here, coach.
I don't know. But, you know, like, our whole thing, to be honest, is, I think we've had a lot of success this year because we've been focused on one day at a time, you know, and that always is the cliche thing, but, you know, but it really has kept our focus on the day and the task, whether it's practice or a game. I've been really proud of the girls for that. So we'll focus on that later when possibility comes.
Okay. Before I let you go, at least, the buses at Helena Public Schools aren't the greatest. So the road trip tonight, extra layers, blankets for the team, but at least you don't have to worry about the negative temperatures like Capital does tomorrow when they travel, because you guys will at least have somewhat nice weather today.
No, that is true. You know, weather's always a factor in Montana. I think throughout the 4 years I've been coaching, there's always been a game that has been canceled or rescheduled, due to weather. And obviously when the weather report came out, kind of looked at Wednesday and he said, okay, hey, we're glad we're getting on a bus Wednesday, cause we don't want to be doing that Thursday. So, you know, again, we'll, you know, get on the bus and hopefully be, well rested, as best as we can, and, and go get another win.
Well, good luck tonight, Coach. Congrats on the four straight, but keep it rolling. We'll talk next week.
All right. Thanks. Appreciate it.
That is Ben Dudek, head coach, Helena High Girls, joining us off the wall, Man Cave, and a good one tonight at Sentinel. Let's take a break. We'll come back. When we return, we'll check in across town with Katie Garcin-Forba. They got a nice win, the Bruin girls did last night. We'll talk to her. And is she willing to do the bubble bath for state tournament, for state title? We'll ask her. Aubrey McMaster from Jefferson High is going to join us coming up as well. Opening segment brought to you by Montana Custom Log Homes. We call it the walk-up. They are veteran-owned, family-owned, woman-owned, and operated. 50 years experience, the finest craftsmen available. Three distinct divisions so you can create the log home of your dreams. Most importantly, your budget. Check out Montana Custom Log Homes at yourcustomlog.com. On this day in history, on the way as well. But next is Katie Garcin-Forba here, Jason Walker Show.
Strength, beauty, grit, superior craftsmanship. Our homes have it all. At Montana Custom Log Homes, if you can dream it, we can build it. With three divisions and over 50 years experience, we've got you covered. From a showcase home to a small cabin, we make your vision a reality. Because every cowboy wants a castle for his queen. Montana Custom Log Homes, crafting homes that last for generations.
There's only one place in Helena to cure your craving for Cajun cuisine, and that is Cafe Zydeco. From po' boys and catfish to jambalaya and much more, Cafe Zydeco has the best Cajun this side of New Orleans. And Cafe Zydeco cares about those that take care of us. Military, law enforcement, first responders can get your drink free as a way of saying thank you to those that protect us every day. If you're looking for a place to grab lunch or dinner, get the flavor of the Big Easy in Big Sky Country at Cafe Zydeco on Euclid in Helena.
For more than 20 years, Off the Wall Advertising has built a track record of success helping businesses like yours across the state of Montana. While working with hundreds of businesses, including Jason Walker Media, they have developed a system for success. Off the Wall Advertising utilizes indoor advertising, placing professional billboards in high traffic locations. Let Off the Wall Advertising show you how to get the return on investment you expect from every advertising dollar. Off the Wall Advertising, along with the Jason Walker Show and Continental Divide Radio, have packages for even more bang for your buck. Contact Off the Wall today at offthewallmt.com to schedule a free consultation.
Ah, summer, a time to work in the yard and get all those projects that you've been thinking about all winter done. And when you've had enough, go to Lucky Duck Casino and Bar to cool off, relax, laugh a little or a lot, your choice, have a drink and play your favorite games. There's plenty of new games and your old favorites. Now, if you don't want to work hard and the relaxing part sounds the best to you, then just head over to Lucky Duck Casino and Bar on Dredge behind Jade Restaurant. Happy summer, everyone.
Winters in Montana can be cold and snowy, so let Auto Concepts set up your vehicle with a remote starter system. A remote starter will get your car or truck warmed up on those cold Montana mornings before work or taking the kids to school. Auto Concepts is also the go-to place for everything to enhance your ride, from bumper guards to bed rugs and tonneau covers too. Let Auto Concepts make your commute or drive comfortable. Auto Concepts in Helena, the auto enhancement professionals.
Storewide savings are what you'll find when you shop for new home furnishings at Rucker's Furniture. This means tremendous values on Helena's largest in-stock selection of home furnishings. When you shop Rucker's, you'll find storewide savings on the furniture you want for every room in your home. And you'll also find our selection of Serta iComfort, the most comfortable beds in Helena. 12-month financing is available with approved credit on most purchases over $289. Ask for details. You'll find storewide savings at Rucker's Furniture, 1010 Dearborn, Helena.
Welcome back to the Jason Walker Show.
Welcome back, Jason Walker Show. Wednesday, January the 10th. 10 days into the new year already. Can you believe it? Make sure you go to Continental Divide Radio and just say, Alexa, play Continental Divide Radio. Or download at the Apple Store and listen to the music of your memories, including Chris Ledoux. We play it all, man. Alternative, country, rock, rap, 70 years worth of music. And it's not just the hits we play, too. We play some of the best, like, album cuts. Songs that weren't released to radio. And we don't sugarcoat. We don't edit. We don't radio edit for anything. Great music. How you would hear it on the album or CD is how you hear it at Continental Divide Radio. Back in the Off-the-Wall Mancave, this segment brought to you by Rutgers Furniture and a fourth straight win for the Capital Girls last night. Improved to 4-3. And joining us now to talk about that win is the head coach. And is she ready for cold? Katie Garcin-Forba joins us now on the Jason Walker Show. Well, Coach, you open up conference play. A couple of very nice wins, both on the road at tough places to play. But you've got to be feeling pretty good. How about we get to Katie Garcin-Forba and not Guy Almquist? Yeah, let's try that one again. Here we go. Here she is. All right, Coach, it is another week, another couple of wins for Capital Girls. Haven't been able to say that in a while, but what have you won? Three straight, all in conference? That's impressive.
Yeah, well, we won four straight because we won one coming into the break. So won our last, but we won our last four. Our girls are, you know, starting to see the success of their hard work. And we told them in preseason, we knew we'd had a tough preseason with, you know, West and Skyview and Gallatin. And so I think that was really good for us to go through that and then be able to, you know, apply what we learned and just keep getting better and really focusing on us through that stretch, I think has paid off as we've gotten into conference play.
It helps when you have Taylor Sayers leading the way and she's back from Hawaii, which is always good, but she had a very nice night last night, but the whole team had a great weekend at home to open up conference play against the Kalispell schools. And then you keep it rolling last night. What's going on? What happened? Why is it so good right now?
I really think our defense has been pretty outstanding. You know, we've haven't given up more than 24 points to a team in the last four games.
Wow.
I think Chris Peterson showed in his, you know, what he shared last night that we're giving up an average of 4.7 points per quarter, which is stellar. And we know that there's going to be teams that are going to be able to, you know, score. And so we've got to take away their best players and make them run their offense through others. And, but I really think that our kids have just been a ton of ownership into what we're trying to do on the defensive end. And then that leads to success for us and opportunities on the offensive end. And, you know, they've all kind of owned their role. I shouldn't say kind of, they've all stepped up and really owned their role, and they know where they need to be in our rotations. They know what they need to do for us on the floor. And it's really cool seeing that develop over the last couple of games. And I think that just kind of feeds them and builds their energy.
Talking with Capital Girls coach, Katie Garcin-Forba, Jason Walker Show. Great win last night, obviously. And now you are supposed to go travel tomorrow over to Hellgate, I believe. But what do you expect from the Knights? They got a nice overtime win last night against Helena High.
That was on the boys' side.
Oh, it was. You're right.
They
yeah.
lost
I can
the
read.
Girls by 10. But they're going to be that's second loss in a row for them. And so they're going to come out feisty. They're going to come out ready to play for us. So much of it is limiting second chances for players for them. And they've got a, you know, a good scorer in Chloe Larson, and everything kind of runs through her. And so we've got to, you know, look at adjusting our game plan a little bit because she's a big player. She's 5'11", plays the guard. But for us, it's handling their physicality and then just they bring a different type of intensity. They bring a different type of, you know, just they're physical. They'll make adjustments to be able to fend. You know, I assume they'll throw something different at Taylor than what we saw even last night. And so, you know, for us, it's other players stepping up and just making those adjustments once we see what they do. But yeah, it's a big road game for us. It's a big one to go there. It's not an easy gym to play in. And we know that they'll come out and they'll pressure the entire game and they'll be physical on both ends of the floor.
You mentioned Chloe. She had 12 last night. They have Ellie Reed as well. They've got a couple of good players aside from Chloe that can score, and that helps. When you look at film, obviously it's Chloe Larson, like you said, but they've got other girls. So how do you defend against a team that is balanced, kind of like yourself?
I think the biggest thing, again, is just knowing what they're gonna try and run, and then taking away their best options out of their sets and their looks. We know every play has a counter. Every good player should have a counter move. And so what that is, and limiting it. And then I think being able to put pressure on other players and make it hard for them to just get into their offense is another focus for us. And so if we can put a little bit of pressure on them, take some time off the shot clock, the full court and the half court, and then force them to make quicker decisions on the offensive end for a team like that that has a couple different weapons. I think that's an important thing for us.
We talk about Taylor. We talk about Anna Cockhill. Katie Sheridan continues to just play solid basketball, and apparently it's something to do with the name Katie that makes you a pretty solid on the hoop or on the floor.
Yeah, Katie has had a phenomenal year for us so far. She came in just in such a great headspace for us and wanting to just do whatever she needed to do to help our team this year. And that was a big focus with her. And, you know, one of the coolest conversations, I have preseason meetings with all of them, and we talked about her role. And her biggest thing, she's like, I just want to have a role on the team. I don't care what it looks like. I just want to own my role. I want to thrive in it, and I want to just do what is best for us to have success. And so for us to be able to put her on a player like Emily McElmurray last night and be able to get her out and kind of lead our defense along with Anna. And I mean, she is making great decisions. She's playing really unselfish basketball, but she is a kid who has just totally owned her role and is embracing it and thriving in it. And it's just doing everything that I need her to do for our team at this point.
How nice is it to have role players like that? And then, you know, they're so good defensively that they don't show up in the box scores a lot, but when they do, it just goes to show that the rest of the team, I think, maybe recognizes what they're doing in helping the team win, and they want to get them some points too.
Mm-hmm. I think one of the coolest things, so after last night's win, you know, Taylor has a great game. She has 18, like they had to throw a block on one at her in the second half. I mean, they're just like that. And one of the first things, I go in the locker room after with the kids, and I said, you know, so you guys recognize what they were trying to do there? Because we're trying to coach them through it in the middle of the game, but they're high school players. And they're like, what is a box and one? What does that mean? I'm like, all right, let's unpack that one for a minute. But one of the coolest things about it was, is I explained what it was, and Katie Sheridan in that moment said, it just says that Taylor is that good. And I love that moment, because then in the next breath, we had multiple players turn and look at Katie and tell her what a great job she did defensively. And it's those moments, and we talk to our kids a lot about culture. We talk to them a lot about, you know, what that means for us and resiliency, and there's going to be stuff that gets thrown at them. But at the end of the day, they have to stay together, and they have to be great teammates to each other. And what does that look like? And I think we've seen that on multiple occasions. And so when a player like Katie makes great plays, her teammates get excited for her because she does it in such an unselfish and genuine way to really do what's best for our team.
That's awesome. Katie Garcin-Forba joining us here, Jason Walker Show. Are you ready for the cold?
No. Every time the cold hits, I look at my husband and I'm like, why are we here? And he's like, because you're a basketball coach and basketball is in January. I'm like, oh, dang it. But no, I am not ready for the cold. I actually hate the cold. I would rather have a lot of snow, honestly, and have it in like the 20 degree range than the minus 30s. And my husband just got a diesel truck, and I was like, why did you do that in the middle of winter? Now that's the whole thing, but it's fine.
Yeah, as long as it doesn't gel up, you'll be okay.
Yes.
And they're loud when they warm up.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Neighbors probably loving Matt right now.
Okay.
You guys don't have the greatest buses in Helena Public Schools. So how do you approach a road trip mentally with the girls knowing that it's going to be cold on that bus?
You better dress warm. And if anybody, like, we have warned you that it's going to be cold, and it means layers, and it means good layers, and it means wear your wool socks and not your Crocs. Wear good boots. And if you choose not to, then you do not get a complaint.
Bring blankets. It's fine.
Bring blankets. Bring extra layers. You can take those off when you get to the gym. But at the end of the day, like, no, I mean, we just tell them it is what it is. Dress warm, bring warm clothes, you know, bring plenty of, you know, water, food for them. You know, we have street bin and stuff like that, but it's, yeah, we just tell them dress warm, and you know, it's winter sports in Montana.
You know what? I bet Taylor shows up, because I've known her since she was a little girl. I bet she shows up for the bus trip in, you know, shin high socks. She'll have some, probably wearing some flip flops or shower shoes of some sort. Shorts and a hoodie.
She'll wear the joggers because got the team issued travel pants.
Yep.
And like jackets and stuff. But she will. Yeah, she's. You never know with Taylor. And as a side story about Taylor, so she runs all of our post timeout cheer or whatever we say. And so I've designated her. She's one of our captains. I'm like, you say what we're saying. And I am still in the habit of doing it though, because I've always done it for the last 14 years of my career. So I told her one game last week, I said, okay, if I say what we're saying, you know, if I say, okay, Bruins on three, slap my hand and like, tell me to knock it off because that's your job. And so last night I did it and she reached up and slapped my hand. Like, well, that's a senior for you that knows you as a coach and you've got a relationship with.
100%. And it helps when you're in the lead, too. I mean, I wouldn't do that. Yes. I wouldn't slap my coach's hand away if we're down 10.
No. She might, though. She gets sassy, and I dig it. She's a funny one.
Nothing great today, but Monday was National Bubble Bath Day. Last time you took a bubble bath.
Oh, I don't know. We have a hot tub, so we tend to use the hot tub. I'm not a big bath. I'm not a big bubble bath person or a big bath person. It's been years.
Okay.
With confidence, it's been years.
Okay, well, I've got a couple coaches thinking about this. If you win state, you've got to do the show from a bubble bath, strategically placed cameras, but that's your incentive to win state.
Is that an incentive?
Almquist is going to think about it.
That worries me. That actually terrifies me. Guy, please don't think on that too long.
Well, he said yesterday, he goes, if you win it and there's that moment of euphoria right afterwards, coaches will agree to a lot of stuff at that moment. So.
Totally. Yeah, no, there's a lot of truth to that. I mean, I remember, like, Charlie at West said he'd shave his beard. Like, there's, yeah, you do. Your willingness to do things you wouldn't normally do at that moment definitely changes.
Okay, what are you willing to do?
Oh.
Because you don't have a beard that I know of. You're not going to shave your head.
No. So. No, on both of those. I can confirm I do not have a beard and I'm not going to shave my head. That is a good question. You know, for when we won it in 2021 for our goals, like we had our game goals, and I told our girls, they always wore their Crocs and it'd be snowing and they'd wear their stupid Crocs, and I hate Crocs.
I do too.
And so I bought a pair and I told them that if we hit every single one of our goals in a game, I will coach practice in a pair of Crocs that next practice. And I had to do it. And I hated every minute of it. But so that's probably the craziest thing that I've done, which is not that crazy, but the girls thought it was hilarious because they loved their Crocs. And so I had to coach in a pair of Crocs and they were loving every minute of it. But I don't know what I think, the furthest I'd be willing, like what I'd be willing to do.
Okay. I'll keep thinking, but yeah. Guys in on it, and Anthony Canol too, Jefferson.
Gotcha.
So
yeah, I'll think about what I'm willing to, what my parameters would be.
I mean, you know, it's got to be fun for the team.
Right, right.
You know, we've done the...
Just with a bubble bath, it's not like you have the team in there with you. So it's like, you know, it's kind of right. weird for them.
Let's keep this rated PG, will ya? The feds are listening. I don't need any issues here. yeah, we'll come up with something. Hey, good luck. Stay warm this weekend. Temperatures are going to start plummeting today. We've already reached our high for the day. So,
oh gosh.
Yeah. It's just going to go downhill, but we won't reach negative temperatures until you're already in Missoula tomorrow.
That's great to hear. I love that when we come over Mac Pass, it's -40 like we had last year at one point.
Yeah.
Winter sports in Montana.
You got to love it. Hey, you're a coach. That's why you're here. You haven't applied for jobs down south anywhere warm. So.
No, but I can't say that it's not appealing.
Let's see, Matt, do you want to live in Phoenix in January or Montana? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good luck this week. And, I have a quick, is Crosstown a doubleheader next week?
It is. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, that's a good question. So our freshman sophomore team for both boys and girls play on Monday of next week for Crosstown with the holiday. And then boys and girls JV and varsity is going to be a doubleheader on the 19th. So it'll be really cool because we'll rotate JV boys, JV girls, JV, you know, varsity boys, varsity girls. And so I think that'll be really fun just to have have everything in the gym or everybody in the gym together. And then it's also our pink night. So shameless plug. We're doing a fundraiser for, somebody that has strong ties to Capital High School and raising money for them as they go through their breast cancer fight. So I'll share more on your show next week on that with another shameless plug. But yeah, next week will be a great week for, just community, supporting somebody in our community, and then obviously some great basketball.
Well, I'll do a shameless plug before I let you go. I will be calling those games on SWX.
Oh, awesome.
So... There you go.
There you go.
I'll have the suit on, the tie on. I'll be looking fly.
Nice, nice. Well, I'm glad to hear it. Now we know what's coming for next week.
That's right. SWX, baby. It's all over the place. Okay. And I get to choose, I think, because I have to do color one game, play-by-play another. So I think I'll do play-by-play of the girls game.
Okay. Yeah. Should be a battle between... It should be a fun couple Crosstown games.
I think so.
They're playing really well. Boys are starting to kind of find their stride. Our boys are definitely finding their stride. So it should be a fun day of basketball.
I look forward to it. We'll talk next week about it. How's that?
That sounds great.
Get a win tomorrow or this doesn't mean anything. I'm just kidding.
I was going to say something snarky, but I'll save it for next week.
Oh, I cannot wait. Katie Garcin-Forba. Hey, good luck tomorrow. Safe travels, and we'll talk next week.
Sounds good. Thanks.
KGF, Katie Garcin-Forba joining us. Capital Girls, they've won 4 in a row and unbeaten in the Western AA. So very cool. Quick break. Come back, and we'll head down the I-15 to Boulder, and we'll check in with girls coach of the fifth-ranked girls team in Class B, Aubrey McMaster from Jefferson. She joins us next here, Jason Walker Show.
Store-wide savings are what you'll find when you shop for new home furnishings. Store-wide savings are what you'll find when you shop for new home furnishings at Rutgers Furniture. This means tremendous values on Helena's largest in-stock selection of home furnishings. When you shop Rutgers, you'll find store-wide savings on the furniture you want for every room in your home. And you'll also find our selection of Serta iComfort, the most comfortable beds in Helena. 12-month financing is available with approved credit on most purchases over $299. Ask for details. You'll find store-wide savings at Rutgers Furniture, 1010 Dearborn, Helena.
There's only one place in Helena to cure your craving for Cajun cuisine, and that is Cafe Zydeco. From po' boys and catfish to jambalaya and much more, Cafe Zydeco has the best Cajun this side of New Orleans. And Cafe Zydeco cares about those that take care of us. Military, law enforcement, first responders can get your drink free as a way of saying thank you to those that protect us every day. If you're looking for a place to grab lunch or dinner, get the flavor of the Big Easy in Big Sky Country at Cafe Zydeco on Euclid in Helena.
Strength, beauty, grit, superior craftsmanship. Our homes have it all. At Montana Custom Log Homes, if you can dream it, we can build it. With three divisions and over 50 years experience, we've got you covered. From a showcase home to a small cabin, we make your vision a reality. Because every cowboy wants a castle for his queen. Montana Custom Log Homes, crafting homes that last for generations.
For more than 20 years, Off the Wall Advertising has built a track record of success helping businesses like yours across the state of Montana. While working with hundreds of businesses, including Jason Walker Media, they have developed a system for success. Off the Wall Advertising utilizes indoor advertising, placing professional billboards in high traffic locations. Let Off the Wall Advertising show you how to get the return on investment you expect from every advertising dollar. Off the Wall Advertising, along with the Jason Walker Show and Continental Divide Radio, have packages for even more bang for your buck. Contact Off the Wall today at offthewallmt.com to schedule a free consultation. Winters in Montana can be cold and snowy, so let Auto Concepts set up your vehicle with a remote starter system. A remote starter will get your car or truck warmed up on those cold Montana mornings before work or taking the kids to school. Auto Concepts is also the go-to place for everything to enhance your ride, from bumper guards to bed rugs and tonneau covers too. Let Auto Concepts make your commute or drive comfortable. Auto Concepts in Helena, the auto enhancement professionals.
Ah, summer, a time to work in the yard and get all those projects that you've been thinking about all winter done. And when you've had enough, go to Lucky Duck Casino and Bar to cool off, relax, laugh a little or a lot, your choice, have a drink and play your favorite games. There's plenty of new games and your old favorites. Now, if you don't want to work hard and the relaxing part sounds the best to you, then just head over to Lucky Duck Casino and Bar on Dredge behind Jade Restaurant. Happy summer, everyone.
Welcome back to the Jason Walker Show.
Welcome back, Jason Walker Show. This segment brought to you by Bowser's Lucky Dog Casino. Make sure you drink and gamble responsibly. Hanging out in the off-the-wall man cave on this day in history, coming up, the walk-off, and much more. But it is time to head down to Boulder and check in with girls coach for the first time this year. Her name is Aubrey McMaster. And the Panther girls ranked 5th in Class B, and she joins us now here, Jason Walker Show. All right, coach, been a while since we talked. I thought I'd give you a little bit of a breather, but how's life for the McMaster clan?
Oh, life is pretty good. I mean, it's been a long break, especially for the kids. The high schoolers start back at school today, so they had a long time off. So it's been relaxing.
Relaxing, and yet parents are going, when do you go back to school?
Right, yeah.
Nice weekend for you guys. Break it down for me.
Yeah. I mean, Ennis was a great team. We had Whitehall before that on Thursday, road game. So that was fun. And then Ennis was an intense game. I mean, they're a good team. They have a good coach. Jordan Overstreet's a great coach. But we were able to pull out 2 wins, which was nice. I mean, I think there's something about the kids being able to go to school every day and have practice after school and then play their game. So it was a weird week for sure, having nothing but basketball.
Yeah, they were ready to play someone else.
Yeah, yeah.
Ryan Eveland, 16 on Saturday against NS. You guys were down at the half. What'd you say in the locker room?
I mean, I was pretty intense the first half, so we kind of kept it lighthearted at halftime. I mean, I just told them, you know, it is what it is. We just got to go out there, do our best, do what we can get done. And remember that it's just basketball, and it's not going to matter in 5 years. So we're not going to try not to worry about it for 5 minutes. And we did come out a little lighter in the second half, so that was really nice to see.
Look at you breaking out like philosophy here.
I probably just saw that somewhere the day before. And then
that is awesome. But no, you're sitting there just, and it's intriguing to me how coaches handle halftimes, whether you're up or whether you're down. I mean, it's just one of those deals where it's like, when do you decide before you go into the locker room how you're going to handle it?
I mean, usually me and my coaches kind of have a little chit chat before we walk into a locker room. This was only our second time this year being down at half. So it was a little different. Normally, I mean, I just go in there. I'm like, okay, great job. Let's keep doing what we're doing. but yeah, it was a little frustrating the first half. So I did kind of have to take a step back and realize, okay, they're just a bunch of little kids. I gotta chill out a little bit.
Yeah. They're still, 15 to 18 year old girls that.
Yeah.
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 I had a teenage girl once. I get it. And I got another one coming up soon. Well, she's
about
8 years away from it, but yeah.
Yeah.
We talk about Miss Eveland a little bit. You guys got to have a balanced attack, especially on Thursday against Whitehall. But, Hannah Stevens had 12, Brooklyn Miller, Mackenzie Lang. I mean, it's nice, I'm sure, when you are able to spread the ball around. And I know you want someone to get hot and lead the way, but when the rest of the team can contribute like that, you guys are, that's a pretty intense way to play and tough for opponents.
Yeah, I know. We've been talking, like, it must be hard to watch us because we don't really do much. We just go out there and play as fast as we can every single time. But, it's been great to see all these different girls step up, especially when, I mean, during Ennis, they were pretty much face guarding Mackenzie Lang the whole game. So it was awesome to see a few of the younger girls step up again.
And that balance, like I said, it makes you guys dangerous. What have you won, seven in a row now as you head into this weekend?
Yeah. Nice. It's been fun for sure, yeah.
Do you talk about rankings?
Not really. I mean, the whole state rankings came out and we were fifth, so I just kind of sent it to them in our group chat, and I was like, fifth in the state, let's go. But, I mean, other than that, we just try to take it week by week.
Okay. Jefferson girls coach Aubrey McMaster, our guest here. All right. Townsend on Thursday, White Sulphur Springs on Saturday. Townsend, David Lawson, great coach, great guy. He's still implementing a system in his second year, but what do you expect? Because they have some talent there down in Townsend.
Yeah. Well, they've been doing great this year too. And they play fast like we do. So I think it'll be a great game for both teams to get the fast pace from the other team as well. And I love their coach. He's a great guy. So, we're just going to try to play our game. And I think our game is pretty similar to theirs. So it should be really fun.
You look at it and you guys are, you're sitting there, you're both fast paced up and down the floor, get going, get rolling. But usually these games sometimes can turn into, or not usually, but sometimes these games can turn into low scoring slugfests because you almost play too fast, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. It gets really intense and sometimes out of control. Sometimes it looks like it's not a basketball game, but it is hard to control. Sometimes you just need like a timeout to calm everybody down and, remember that we can go 100 miles an hour, but still be under control.
Exactly. What's that saying? Play slow to play fast.
Yeah.
Or something like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
They're balanced just like you guys. They had 11 players score on Saturday in their win over Lone Peak, but it starts with Ella Bagger. I mean, she's a tremendous athlete, a great student athlete. How do you plan on defending her and then focus on the balance that they have too?
Yeah. I mean, I was thinking about it. I was like, well, should we just face guard her or what? But they are very balanced all throughout. So we've had a couple
sophomores step up and play some good defense. So we'll just see. We might switch out who's guarding her all throughout the game and just kind of see who's playing good D that day.
That's a decent little plan. It's almost, yeah. It's almost like you know the game a little bit there, Coach.
I mean, well, I wouldn't go as far as to say that, but
let's see. It is National Bubble Bath Day today. Are you do you take bubble baths? Are you a fan?
You know, I don't take baths anymore. I used to, but I mean, there's something about like sitting in your own dirt. Just kind of rubs me the wrong way now.
I never looked at it like that.
Yeah, I know.
Interesting.
It is kind of weird. I mean, I guess you could do a shower first and then a bath.
Well, that's a lot of hot water.
I know. Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Let's see. So I've got a bet with Canole that if they win divisionals, he's got to do the show from a bubble bath. I don't want to do that with you. I want to make that clear. I just, but we've got to, we got to come up with something for the girls for you guys. And it doesn't have to be a bubble bath. I mean, we have other days we could look at as we get closer to districts and divisionals.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's look at other days for sure. Make it fun.
Yeah. Cause
a bubble bath is easy for Anthony. I mean, he's playing it safe.
Well,
you get to relax.
But he's 6'3", so you know he's.
That's true.
It's kind of it's kind of tough. I don't have that problem because I've never sniffed close to 5'6".
That's funny.
Always been 5'5", but.
Well, that's okay.
Hey, good things come in small packages, right?
Yeah, that's a good motto to live by.
Well, Coach, I'm looking forward to the rest of the year and our chats each week as you guys look for a couple more wins this week. Good luck. Thanks for joining us. And, yeah, best of best. Well, try to stay warm this weekend, too. It's going to get cold.
Yeah. Yeah, no kidding. Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I'm looking forward to the rest of the season.
That is Aubrey McMaster joining us, an interview we did on Monday. Good luck to the Panthers. Let's see here. Did we have anything else pressing? I don't think so. Let's check the... Is there any breaking news? I don't think so. Nope, not at all. Okay, we're good to go. Still on this day in history, it is January the 10th. It is Wednesday. We talked a lot about bubble baths. That was Monday. It's House Plant Appreciation Day, Save the Eagles Day, not the band or the football team, but actual Eagles. Bittersweet Chocolate Day as well. So, let's see. On this date, 1982, The Catch. Dwight Clark from Joe Montana. 58 seconds to go to beat the Cowboys. Go on to win the Super Bowl after that NFC championship. 1986, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar of the Lakers scored his 34,000th career point. At that time, the only one to reach that milestone. Wayne Gretzky became the NHL's all-time leading scorer. Combined regular season and playoff points, 1989. He had four assists to bring his total to 2011. Vancouver Canucks center Mark Messier, 1998, the sixth player to record 1,000 assists. George Foreman turned 75 today. Let's see, a couple of people, a couple of deaths on this day. 1917, Buffalo Bill Cody, he was 70. And in 1977, Ruth Wakefield died. Ruth Wakefield created the Toll House cookie, the first chocolate chip cookie. She died at the age of 73. Let's do this.
We're almost at the end of the show. What did we learn? And what did he miss? Time for the walk-off.
The walk-off presented by Cafe Zydeco, where the Big Easy meets the Big Sky. Stop in for the best Cajun this side of New Orleans. I think I'm going to go there tonight after the little one has gymnastics. I think that'll be a good post-gymnastics dinner. All right. I like it. I like it a lot. I think that's a good idea.
Thanks to our guests today, Ben Dudek, Katie Garcin-Forba, Aubrey McMaster. Back tomorrow, Tyler Patrick, Ty Ridgeway, and Carson Bender. Can we convince any of those three to do a bubble bath if they win divisionals and get to the state tournament? We'll find out tomorrow. Stay warm. For weather updates, go to Continental Divide Radio. Say, Alexa, play Continental Divide Radio. Download at the Apple Store. If you missed anything, jasonwalkershow.com. You can also go to jasonwalkermedia.com. Back again tomorrow. Have a wonderful Wednesday and stay warm, because the cold is going to roll in tonight and tomorrow and get really cold this weekend. This is another great Jason Walker Show. See ya.
The Jason Walker Show is produced by the Jason Walker Media Company. Any reuse, rebroadcast, or retransmission without the express written consent of the Jason Walker Show is strictly prohibited. Just listen, watch, and enjoy.